Hello, church, saints of God, Christians. Today I want to talk about Periscope preachers. Periscope preachers and even some YouTube preachers. I have nothing against people encouraging the body of Christ via YouTube and via Periscope. I have nothing against people conducting prayers via Periscope. However, what I am not so convinced and happy about, the spirit within me is grieved when I see this, is that what I see on Periscope is really astonishing me right now. I downloaded it in order to follow some preachers, men of God, and it rings. Basically, my phone just give me a notification of a Periscope video every 15 minutes, every hour, or every 2 hours. And you feel like, oh, I have to watch, or I'm going to miss my blessing. And that's what I don't like. It's that sense of you must watch so that you must get your blessing or the prayers. And I like it that someone can pray for you over Periscope, because I think what most people need right now, people that are not pastors, people that are not shepherds in the body of Christ, people that are the sheep, like I believe I'm one of the sheep. We want to follow someone. We want to follow, like people followed Christ. But I'm disappointed because we go there, we drop everything we are doing, we go there to listen to a message or to listen to someone pray. And we behind the screen, you don't see us, the Periscope preachers, the YouTube preachers, you don't see us. But we have real needs. And it doesn't have to be financial needs. Some of us have diseases, some of us are unemployed, some of us feel that they have curses following them, and you know they feel like they can't, their lives cannot go forward. But every time I go on Periscope, I'm trying to get some deliverance or answers or prayers for maybe a disease or a situation in my life. I feel like every time I hear a good message or even during a prayer, at some point they are like, if you really agree or accept this, you have to plant a seed, you have to plant a seed. And I'm not someone who is against giving tithes or giving offering. I do it joyfully, but you have to understand that we are people who are working hard for the money we have. We don't go on Periscope and ask people to give us money. I don't go on Periscope, I don't go on YouTube and ask for someone to give me money, okay? The money we earn is hard to receive. We have to go into offices where people are not Christian, where people are full of demonic spirits, where people, we are not enjoying our time there, where people are attacking us on a constant basis with gossips, with backbiting. So the money God is blessing us with is not easy for us to have. And when we do give it to you, because we do, when you ask for a seed, okay, you've prayed from until midnight, seed, plant a seed of $12 or $120, so that in 12 hours, God is going to do this for you. This is what I hear all the time on Periscope. And we do. We plant the seed. And then what I don't like is you plant the seed, you never even get a thank you. You send an email for personal prayers. You may get an answer once and then that's it. It's like the person has forgotten about you. You don't know what's going on. And what you have to understand is that the person behind it, who is sending the seed, who is sending the email, really needs to hear from the man of God. Really need that special touch. And has obeyed the instruction you gave. You said plant a seed, Send me an email. And we do that. We plant the seed, send an email, we don't get anything. I just want to read to you. In Matthew 18:12, King James Version. How think ye, if a man have 100 sheep, and one of them be gone astray, does he not leave the 99 and goes into the mountains and seeks that which is gone astray? This is Jesus speaking. It's also found in the book of Luke. I'm going to read it to you. In the book of Luke, Luke chapter 15, verse 4 and 5. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after that which is lost until he find it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. Right now, what I can say is that the good shepherd, the real shepherd, is Jesus Christ. He was a real shepherd when he was walking on the earth. He really cared about healing people. He didn't ask for money for that. He just healed people. He resurrected the dead. He cast out devils out of people without asking for money. And was really caring what the people are going through. He fed the thousands when people were following him, just like you. I'm talking to you, Periscope preachers. You have people following you on your Periscope, thousands of people. Jesus had people following him, and when he didn't want to send them back home without food, and so he multiplied the fishes and the bread, and he nourished 5,000 people. What I'm trying to say is that from us, the masses, the sheep who are following, who are trying to follow you guys, sometimes we need to be fed. And you think that you're feeding us the word and the, you're feeding us the word and the prayers. We can read the word at home. We can pray also with our family or church members if we go to church. When we go and look for you, you are telling us. The thing is that people are leaving churches now and are going on to Periscope and follow Periscope preachers and YouTube preachers because we don't see the supernatural in our church. We don't see a disease being healed. And so that when you get a disease, you're even scared to tell the people of your church because too much gossip and backbiting also in the church. And so we turn to Periscope preachers and YouTube preachers to pray for us, people that we can see that supposedly they have had people being healed by their prayers, and they show the supernatural, they cast out devils, and they command disease to come out. So we follow you on Periscope because we don't have that happening in our churches nearby in our neighborhood. But don't take it for granted. I'm here talking for the masses and the sheep. And if you truly want to have people following you, giving you money and seed money, you're not working, you're just preaching a word and people give you money. I have nothing against you selling books, people buying books, but you just say a word, you say people plant a seed, and then you're satisfied, you go to sleep happy. But the person who sowed the seed was expecting something, expecting to be healed, expecting a prayer, expecting a word from that man of God, from the email or something, and you're not getting it, you're not giving it. You forget about the person. To you, it's just one name, one email. That person who has sent, who has sowed in your ministry, sent money, not even a thank you. That's what really disappoints me, because it has happened to me. You know, I have a personal need. I have something that I want prayers for. I'm trying to get in touch with those people, and you give money, you plant seeds, and nothing. And so, all I know is that God says that you'll be judged more harshly. Everyone that claims to be a master or a leader or pastor, you'll be judged more harshly. Jesus was a good shepherd. Follow his example. He never asked for seeds, money, for people to be healed, for him to cast out devils and break curses and all that. He never asked for money. People, yes, we have to pay our tithes and give offering. But stop kind of profiting from our needs, profiting from our misery and our state of desperation for you to just say, give a seed and God will do this for you, and then nothing happens. Stop saying that. It's not fair for us, and it just makes us more people more against the things of God. Show the true love of Christ. Go after the one sheep that has gone astray. Go after it. Follow through with what you're saying. Follow through the emails. If you say you're going to pray for the person, follow through. And I know that it must be difficult with thousands of people following you, but that's what you choose to do. You choose to on putting on Periscope. You choose on having people following you. You choose on saying promises over the airwave of saying that, yes, God is going to do this for you. Plant a seed. Then you have to follow through. People need personal prayers. Jesus, I don't know if Jesus was doing mass healings. I know that masses were around him, but to my knowledge, he would touch one person, then another, one by one. One by one. So if I'm wrong, please feel free to send me messages via YouTube. I believe I'm also going to put my email, the email that I use for this YouTube channel, on the description of this message. Feel free to email me, but if I'm wrong. And if I'm wrong, I'm sorry. I don't want to cause division in the body of Christ. I just have to give what I'm feeling right now about Periscope preachers and YouTube preachers. Please be the good shepherd and follow and go after the one sheep that has gone astray. God bless you.